Good morning, viewers. Today I am present before you with the novel written by Amitabh Ghosh entitled The Hungry Tide. In today's podcast, I will be talking about this particular novel, and I hope that this podcast proves to be of help in making you understand the novel in a better way. I have taken help of some of the internet sites and especially an article written by Terry Tomsky entitled Amitabh Ghosh's Anxious Witnessing and the Ethics of Action in The Hungry Tide. In the end, in the description box below, you can check out the link of my literature blog and can get this entire content there. So here I begin. Amitabh Ghosh's novel, The Hungry Tide, written in 2004, dramatizes the impact of environmental conservation projects upon communities of subaltern humans. Set in the Sundarbans region of rural Bengal, it registers and responds to the social and economic disparities both in India's past and its present. By drawing his central characters from the pool of his implied audience, that is to say the middle-class educated reader, and placing them in unfamiliar circumstances, Ghosh articulates a more general political imperative to recuperate suppressed subaltern histories and to advance their calls for social justice. The novel engages the overwhelming question, how should we, as readers and writers, position ourselves in relation to today's geopolitical inequalities in spaces that are both conceptually and geographically distant? The Hungry Tide locates the source of justice in the civic possibilities created by the agency of the cosmopolitan individual. The Hungry Tide is also a meditation on the transformative power of close human relationships, on how affect configured through altruistic love can shape the political actions and philosophical interests of the characters. According to Terry Tomsky, The Hungry Tide illuminates the ways certain locations and histories give rise to unique sensations, whose effective resonance leads to the formation of a new subjectivity within the individual. The novel not only functions as a testimony to the historically unresolved sufferings of the rural poor, but also implicates its readers. In this novel, Amitabh Ghosh makes the readers responsible for initiating real political change. To catalyze the reaction of effect and cosmopolitan subjectivity, Ghosh deliberately chooses a geography and history that confound the novel's cosmopolitan characters and through them the reader. Bengal's Sundarbans epitomize subalternity. At one level, in other words, this subaltern space reveals that to be an ethically engaged cosmopolitan, one must be sensitive to particularities and local conditions. Ghosh is equally adamant that even the cosmopolitan who possesses this sensitivity can find his or her agency curtailed, even jeopardized by hegemonic apparatuses. As an antidote, Ghosh foregrounds an ethical inquiry exemplified by a form of written testimony that calls attention to collective suffering and urges intervention. In The Hungry Tide, Ghosh looks beyond elite communities and the metropolis to focus on Bengal's Sundarbans, a region of intricate archipelagos. In this rural setting, replete with hunger and catastrophe, he intersects the contemporary narratives of Pia Roy and Kanai Dutt with the past narratives of Kanai's aunt and uncle, Nilima and Nirmal Bose. Ghosh sets up Nirmal as a solitary figure who challenges the silencing of history, rebuking the failures of academics and the international community to speak of the violence perpetrated on the refugees. The writer presents a rethinking of modernist and rationalist forms and an attempt to move towards new forms of power and knowledge. He represents Nirmal's agitated emotional state as the source of his unrequited love and his commitment to a newfound political purpose. The Hungry Tide asserts that the emancipatory possibilities of an interventionist ethics reside within the very structure of transnational middle-class privilege. Ghosh demonstrates how advantageously the cosmopolitan class is placed to utilize the resources within capitalist globalization to contest the subjugation of communities. In invoking an ethical practice of critical self-reflexivity, Ghosh intends to keep us vigilant to notions of responsibility and to remind us of our own, often arbitrary and precarious access to power. But our obligations as citizens of the world in the face of civic inequalities and suppressed histories like those of Morichi Jhapi do not dissolve at the moment of witnessing. Ghosh wants us to act effectively and socio-politically. Only then can we begin to transcend the failures of modern nation-states by inaugurating a new societal order composed of effective and ethically responsive networks. By dramatizing the encounter between bourgeois characters and the traumatic history of people inhabiting the Sundarbans region of Bengal, Ghosh suggests that an unreconstructed cosmopolitanism is incapable of addressing social injustices to effect any positive change. The cosmopolitan must undergo a transformation. So this was the podcast on The Hungry Tide. I hope it proves to be of help to each one of you. Please do like, share and subscribe to the channel, and in the comment section below, share your feedback. Thank you for your valuable time. Here's wishing you a great day ahead.